Hello there! By the end of this video, you should be able to identify electron domain geometries. In order to find electron domain geometries, you first need to understand what an electron domain is. An electron domain is a region where an electron pair is located. A single bond, which is a single line on the Lewis structure, is an electron domain. A double bond, which is two lines on the Lewis structure, is an electron domain. And a triple bond, which is three lines, is an electron domain. A lone pair is also an electron domain, and it is a pair of valence electrons that are not involved in covalent bonding, and there are these pairs of dots that are shown on a Lewis structure. Okay, quick knowledge check. Look at the Lewis structure of NO2-. How many electron domains are around the central atom nitrogen? Pause the video to give yourself some time.
Well, here we can see that the central atom is indeed nitrogen. And then we can see that around the nitrogen atom are two atoms of oxygen, which are attached to the nitrogen through bonds. For the oxygen on the left, we can see that there is a double bond of electrons, which only count as one electron domain. And to the right, you can see that there is one electron bond, which also counts as one electron domain. And at the very top of the central atom nitrogen, you can see that there is an unbonded pair of electrons, which again counts as another electron domain, which gives a total of electron domains for NO2- as 3.
Okay, hopefully you got that right. Let's move on to finding electron domain geometry, which basically involves counting the number of electron domains around the central atom and then finding the electron domain geometry name for that number of electron domains. So let's look at them here. If there are two electron domains around the central atom, the electron domain geometry is called linear. For example, CO2 has two electron domains around the central atom carbon. So it has a linear electron domain geometry. You can remember this because the Lewis structure forms a line. If there are three electron domains around the central atom, the electron domain geometry is called trigonal planar. For example, NO2- here has three electron domains around the central nitrogen atom, so it has a trigonal planar electron domain geometry. You can remember this because there are three electron domains, and there are three sides in a triangle. And you see how the beginnings of these two words match. If there are four electron domains around the central atom, the electron domain geometry is called tetrahedral. For example, CH4 has four electron domains around the central carbon atom. So it has a tetrahedral electron domain geometry. You can remember this because there are four electron domains, just like how there are four cubes in each piece in Tetris. You can see the beginnings of these words are the same. So those are the three types of electron domain geometries you need to know for chemistry SL. Two electron domains around the central atom means linear, three means trigonal planar, and four means tetrahedral. Keep in mind the differences between electron domain geometry and molecular geometry. You only need to count the number of electron domains in order to find electron domain geometry. You don't have to consider whether the electron domains are bonding pairs or lone pairs, as with a molecular geometry. For electron domain geometry, it's in the name. Just count the number of electron domains around the central atom. Okay, here's some quick questions to test your ability to find the electron domain geometry. Once again, pause the video to give yourself some time.
Here we can see that the central atom is phosphorus, and then we can see that it's bonded to three different atoms. We can see that each of these atoms is bonded to the central atom phosphorus with one single bond, which gives us a total of three electron bonds. And then we can see that at the top of the phosphorus atom is a unbonded pair of electrons, which now gives us a grand total of 4 electron domains. Now, referring back to the Earth, to what was said earlier, we can deduce that PF3 has an electron domain geometry of tetrahedral.
Right. Here's the next question.
We can see that for the central atom nitrogen, we can see that there is one electron domain to the right and one electron domain to the left. This would make them compound a linear one, but at the top of that compound, we can see that there's an unbonded pair of electrons, which adds another electron domain, which gives a grand total of 3 electrons. And referring again back to what was said earlier, we can deduce that this has the shape of trigonal planar.
Here is the next question.
Here we can see that there's a single bond connecting the hydrogen atom and the carbon central atom. And on the other side, we can see that there's a triple bond connecting the carbon atom, the nitrogen atom. And since the triple bond only counts as one electron domain, and so does the hydrogen bond, we can see that there's only 2 bonds in this entire compound, which gives the compound a shape of a linear.
Okay, please check the description for a bunch more practice questions with work solutions so you can become more familiar with finding electron domain geometries. That's it for this video. We hope it was helpful.